Hello there, welcome to this video. Let's see together Microsoft OneNote 2016 and everything you need to start with all its features. If you have problems with the accent, enable our closed captions in the video corner. Microsoft OneNote is a software used to take notes and fast information, very useful during a lesson or a discussion. When you open OneNote, a sample document opens, showing you nice tips about how to use the software. This OneNote document, with all its notes inside, is called Notebook, indicated by a simple book icon. To open a new notebook, just go to File on top, and then to New. To start with a new notebook, you need to save it first, browsing and deciding the destination folder in your computer under Browse, or choosing OneDrive, defining the name of the new notebook. Then go to Create, and the new notebook will appear in front of you. A OneNote notebook is composed by a simple structure that reminds the one of a classic book. It is divided in different chapters or sections, and each section is composed by different pages. On top of your workspace, you can select any of your notebooks saved and any of its sections. You can add more sections clicking on the plus button. If you right-click on a section, you can rename, delete, or also export it. You can also edit the sections list, clicking and dragging a section on the left or right. On the extreme right, you can check all the pages inside the opened section. You can add new pages, clicking on Add Page on top, or clicking on the plus arrow on the left, if you want to add a page between two existing pages. As seen for sections, right-click to rename, delete or export. Click and drag a page up or down to change its position in the list. Each page shows on top its title and timestamp. If you don't need those, go to Hide Page Title under View tab. When a page is created, this is completely blank and white. You can click on any point and start typing. But if you go to View on top, you can set the page color and any page line, choosing between rule and grid lines. When using these lines, your notes will be automatically aligned to these lines in order. You can also define the paper size, especially in case you want to print your notes later. You can also use different views on the page. Normal view is the standard one, but you can try full page view to go full screen, or dock to desktop to take notes while using your computer. If you need to regulate the zoom, hold Ctrl down and use your mouse wheel. Let's see now how to take notes and images inside OneNote. As seen, you simply need to click on a point on your page to start typing inside. This will actually create a note, a simple object with text inside. This is contained inside a gray contour, used to locate and define your note. If you click inside, you can edit notes fully. You can move your note clicking and dragging from the thicker contour on top, or from the left gray arrow. If the contour is too short, you can click and drag from the right side to enlarge it. To adjust the font properties, such as style, type, color, and distribution, go to the Home tab on top. These settings are applied on the current text line by default. You can select the text precisely to apply your settings just there, or click once on the gray contour on top to select and apply the settings on the wall note. If you need to cut or copy a note, simply right-click from the contour and paste right-clicking on your page. These notes seen are text notes that can contain text, but also symbols, math equations, links, dates, and tables that you can add through the Insert tab above. If you need to insert dates and time, use the timestamp section. For symbols, go to Symbol. For math equations, click on Equation and use the Equation tools available above, under the Design tab that appears. For web address links, just click on Link, deciding the piece of text and, below, the web address associated. To create tables, go to Table above, deciding the number of rows and columns. Then just type in. The table will size itself automatically. Right-click on the table and go to Table to add or remove rows or columns or color filling and borders. Inside OneNote, you also have other kinds of notes that are managed differently. For example, the pictures and the draw notes. To import pictures, go to the Insert tab and click on Pictures. Browse for your picture and click on Open. The image imported doesn't have any gray contour. To move it, just click and drag it from inside. To scale, use the white notes on the corners. To flip or rotate, click on it and go to Rotate. If you need to draw geometrical shapes, freehand shapes, or Cartesian systems, switch to the Draw tab. Here, you can choose to draw freehand, choosing a line template under Tools, or drawing shapes and systems under Shapes. In both cases, click and drag on your page to draw. You can adjust line color, style and thickness, going to color and thickness above. To manage your drawings, just exit from the draw mode, clicking on the type button on the extreme left of the draw tab. So you can move, scale and rotate each drawing as seen for the pictures before. When you select a draw note, a small dialog box opens. Through this, you can first add tags and tasks that we will see later, adjust the line style through pen properties, or delete the shape. On top, use eraser to delete the draw notes made. To go back typing other notes, click on Type again. You can use lasso select to select more different notes at the same time. In this way, you can move, scale, and rotate all of them together. Inside your page, you can also attach files, going to File Attachment under Insert tab. These will appear with their icons on your page and can be opened double-clicking on it. Special attachments are reserved for Excel spreadsheets and Visio objects. For example, if you click on Excel spreadsheet, you can choose to import the table as a simple icon link, choosing Attach File, or insert the whole Excel table, or its tables and charts. A text note can contain not just text, but also multiple elements, like pictures, tables and files, inside the same gray contour. To import these elements inside a text note, simply import them while having a text note open. In this way, you can move the whole text note, but you will move also all its text and elements inside. Very useful inside OneNote are also tags and tasks. Tags are icons used to highlight a note in a certain way, for example, showing it as something to be done, or something important, adding icons or text filling to the note. To insert tags, simply click on the interested line and click on a tag under Tags in the Home tab. The tag will be added on the line where the gray arrow is. You can also create and customize tags, opening the full list of tags and going to Customize Tags. From the text section, you can also add Outlook tasks. This can be seen as special text that also save the period of time interested. Those are shown through a red flag icon. Plus, if you right-click on the flag, you can change the time of the task, mark it as completed, or link it inside Outlook. In case you have notes that do overlap, you can adjust the object's order going to Arrange under the Draw tab above. Remember that your notebook is automatically saved, so when you close OneNote, you don't need to use any save option. Thanks for watching this video. Check out our channel for more amazing videos about Microsoft Office 2016.